Now, the first laureate we're going to be talking about is Dr. Peter Hegemann. Peter Hegemann is the Hertie Professor for Neurosciences and Experimental Biophysics in the Department of Biology at the Humboldt University in Berlin. And he's being awarded, along with Karl Deisseroth and Edward Boyden, for their work on the discovery of light-gated ion channel mechanisms and the discovery of optogenetics, a technology that has revolutionized neuroscience. I'm going to invite Peter Hegemann to come to the stage now, and his music is Ich würde es wieder tun by Udo Jürgens.
So, dear Dr. Jeanine Rousson, dear Dr. Len Turrell, dear Dr. Schulze, dear members of the Gärtner Foundation, dear members of the Gärtner family, it's a privilege to be introduced into the family. Dear colleagues and friends, it's certainly an extraordinary honor to be selected as a winner of the Gärtner Award 2018, one of the most prestigious science prizes worldwide, and to share the prize with my colleagues and friends, Karl Deisseroth and Ed Boyden. I thank the Gärtner Foundation, the selection committee, and in particular, Jeanette Rousson, who is heading the committee. I'm fully aware that the work and the quality of the committee over many years is what finally designs the reputation of the award, and it stands now. And Joan Dirks is probably one of the most influential people. Person in this direction. But it's not simply the prize. It is a fact that to the fields of optogenetics that is recognized this year, hundreds of outstanding scientists already contributed, and some of them you had your opportunity to meet yesterday and today. To be selected from this extraordinary community is a very special event and a big surprise at the same time. To stand in line with all the great scientists who received the Gärtner Award since 1959 has a very special meaning as well. We are molecular photobiologists working on light-activated proteins, mostly of green algae, as Chlamydomonas. And we haven't done anything else so far. It is greatly a matter of hard work combined with a great portion of luck before research makes it to the top and to a broader application in unrelated fields. But in my case, it is a merit of many outstanding individuals that worked with me over 30 years, and especially those who suffered with me at the early time before we were able to identify the channel rhodopsin. Most of the time, I worked with graduate students and technicians, and only occasionally with postdocs. It was always a matter of delight to see the co-workers develop. And it was a great pleasure to see many of them after they left to start their own business and their own research, how they jumped into new adventures and to come up with some unexpected. I thank all members of my group, present and past, including the non-scientists who are of equal importance because they kept the system running. I'm grateful to my only real teacher, Dieter Oesterhild, who supported me as a young independent scientist without demanding anything except good science, which is a great privilege in these days. It's difficult to find for a young scientist researcher in a German university. I also thank the Canadian scientist Ken Foster, who introduced me to the Agar world as a physicist, which was quite unusual at that time. I should not forget to mention the fruitful collaboration with my co-laureate Karl Deisseroth in particular, who is one of our main collaborators for us for the past 10 years now. He's a main figure for translating the molecular knowledge about light-activated proteins into the large community of neuroscientists for optogenetic applications. Last but not least, I'm grateful to my family and especially my wife, who supported me for the past 35 years. I feel greatly honored that you all came, and I wish you an enjoyable evening and a wonderful party and a fresh and entertaining discussion. Thank you again.